So I love watching movies, and I think there are many out there who enjoy watching movies too. Over the years I watched good flicks and bad flicks, but at some point I started to notice a rather big problem, especially with newer movies. My prime example for this is Blade Runner 2049, which is a pretty good sci-fi movie without a doubt. But maybe you can spot the problem I have with this movie while I was rewatching it. If you guessed that I had to constantly lower and raise the volume while watching, then you're absolutely correct. I have no idea who does it and why, but it often feels like the conversations are kept at a very low volume while the music is basically at the maximum. And I hate that. And no, I'm not crazy. Other people notice such problems too. So I guess there's nothing we can do about this, and we should get used to constantly altering the volume up and down. Right? Wrong! Here's the solution I came up with, and let me tell you that after a lot of blood, sweat and tears, it finally works decently. So sit back and enjoy the journey of how I build it, and thus fix the modern movie industry. Let's get started! This video is sponsored by Brilliant, and you may be familiar with them by now because I mentioned them one or twice before. But let me tell you that Brilliant recently upped the interactivity on their platform to a new level, which I think is fantastic, because in order to properly learn and understand something, you have to do it yourself. For example, you can shift around pseudocodes in order to playfully learn how algorithms and coding syntax works. And that is just one example. You can learn so much more with Brilliant when it comes to STEM topics. You can try it out for free and even get 20% off your first year by visiting brilliant.org/greatscott. First off, let's talk about the electrical fundamentals when it comes to adjusting the volume and how we can measure the sound level. Now, the remote for my soundbar uses an infrared LED for communication, whose send-out data we can have a look at by utilizing an IR receiver. As you can see, it sends out a bunch of ones and zeros that form together different code words the soundbar can understand. But we are only interested in the code for volume up and volume down, which we should be able to send out on our own with an infrared LED as well. And for the sound measurement, all we need is such an electret microphone, which in combination with a suitable amplifier circuit can spit out the sounds it is currently hearing. That means we got an input in the form of a voltage signal and two possible outputs in the form of voltage signals as well. And all we now need is something in the middle that processes the input audio information and decides when to lower or raise the volume. And of course, I went with a microcontroller for this job, an Arduino Pro Mini to be specific. Next, we have to consider how to power this project on the go, for which I initially wanted to use my LiPo charge protect boost circuit that can output 5 volts. The only problem is that the circuit uses a switching regulator, which naturally will always come with a bit of noise, and that can potentially lead to unwanted noise in the audio amp segment. So I ditched that idea and instead went with a LiPo battery plus suitable charge and protect circuits, which I will combine with this linear 3.3 volt regulator. Not only does it obviously spit out stable 3.3 volts, but it also does that down to an input voltage of around 3.35 volts, because it comes with a very low dropout voltage. This is mandatory because our battery only comes with a max voltage of 4.2 volts. So normal linear regulators are out of the question due to the high voltage drop. And as a bonus, I also added a voltage divider and red LED to the final circuit, which will light up when it is time to charge the battery. And speaking of final circuits, here's the schematic for it. And while we already talked about most of the components, there are still some left. For example, the amplifier circuit, which is honestly nothing special, just a typical inverting op-amp configuration. But then there are also two potentiometers, which I will call deadband and react, but more about them during the programming parts. So all in all, the hardware aspect is pretty straightforward and simple. And so was the construction of the circuit on a perf board, which took me around 2 hours in total. And after wiring everything up, it seems like nothing explodes and we're good to go for the programming parts. I started off easy though, by soldering the IR receiver to another Arduino and using the IR remote library in order to extract the code for volume up and volume down. Next, we have to think about the audio signal we want to sample, whose frequency can be as high as around 20 kHz. The problem is that the ADC of our microcontroller, which converts our analog voltage into digital values the microcontroller can work with, clocks with a frequency of 4.8 kHz. To increase this frequency, we have to change the prescaler of the ADC to something like 16, which we can do by adding these lines of code. After then outputting the ADC readings to the serial monitor, or in my case the serial plotter, we can see that everything seems to work just fine. Awesome! And that was the point I positioned the circuit next to my soundbar, started a movie and had a look at lots of different audio waveforms when there were conversations and when there was music. I did this in order to come up with an effective algorithm, which goes something like this. First off, we have to manually set the perfect volume for the conversation volume level, which can look something like this. Then we use the deadband potentiometer in order to obviously adjust the deadband. In this area, the circuit does not care when the loudness changes, which is important because volume fluctuations are essential even when it comes to simple talks. But if the measured values leave the deadband, then the circuit will notice that and wait a certain amount of time before checking if that will happen again. I did this because a loud sound can always be something like a scream or something similar, and we do not want the circuit to lower that. But if the Arduino keeps noticing spikes after certain time intervals, then it knows that it is time to lower the volume. And by the way, you can change the time intervals with the React potentiometer, which lets the system obviously react faster. But anyway, now the circuit will send out the volume down codes until the audio signal is no longer exceeding the deadband, and it will also remember how often it sent out the commands. Next, the system will wait until we reach quieter moments of the movie again, at which point it assumes that the music is over and it will send out the same amount of volume up codes so that we are once again at the sweet spot for conversations. Of course, I didn't explain every little detail here, but overall I thought this control scheme seemed suitable, which is why next I transformed it into an Arduino sketch. And oh boy, was it complicated for me, since I'm honestly not the best programmer. Now I think explaining every single line would get a bit out of hand, but let me tell you that the timer 1 and timer 2 of the Arduino were the key player in this code. Timer 1 creates an interrupt every second, which I use to read in all the not so important voltage dividers. And timer 2 creates an interrupt every 16 to 32 milliseconds, which I use for everything time related when it comes to analyzing the audio signal. And don't think my code worked the first time. I spent a few hours on the floor trying to make it work, and luckily eventually it did. And with that being said, I think you all want to see how this thing performs. So let me just start up the Blade Runner movie and have a listen. It's getting quite loud. Yes, yes, it is dimming it. Perfect. Okay, now we're getting to a quieter moment and now it should go up again. Yes, yes, it works. Perfect. Now, of course, this project is not perfect nor complete, since all that complex programming stole a lot of time from me, which I otherwise would have invested in a decent enclosure. but maybe you're interested in such a device, and thus not only build it yourself, but maybe even add an enclosure and improve the codes, which you will hopefully share. With that being said, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed the project, then consider supporting me through Patreon so that I can make more world-changing projects like this. As always, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time.